All right, we might have to break from this market discussion here for this Florida presser on the timeline of yesterday's attacks in Florida, one of the more devastating attacks on a school. In the meantime, let's take a look at where we stand at the corner. Wall and Broad, the market is racing ahead right now. These are in and out of session highs. Actually, we were a lot higher, I should say, a little bit more than 200 points higher. But we are well into positive territory in the year right now. So can we hold that? And can this be, I think, the fifth day in a row of gains? We've got Market Watchers Gary B. Smith. We've got Melissa Arma back with us. And, of course, Deirdre Bolton. Melissa, your take on what's going on. What do you think?
I was really surprised how much we've recovered since last week. I don't know why I'm shocked, but I am, because I didn't expect that sell-off to happen last week so quickly. But I will tell you this. If we 100% retrace that sell-off 1 week right afterwards, look for smooth sailing in the market to make more records and brand new all-time highs. We got to get over the high of last Monday's sell-off, which we're not that far from doing. We could even do it tomorrow.
Well, that could worry some people as well, right? Did it say you just slough this off like there was no message intended there?
I agree with that. And I do think, as far as market tone goes, I think choppy markets, more choppy trade. Yes, we can hit higher highs. I also think we can hit lower lows. I mean, for me, last week was sentimentally about that. But it does seem so choppy. Choppy trade is here to stay, but it also seems as if the market is willing to support. We saw those 10-year yields hit a four-year high, right before the opening bell today. So the fact that markets are still moving higher says to me, okay, at some level, investors are getting just used to the concept of slightly higher rates.
Yeah, or slightly more volatility. Gary B., what's interesting with this phenomenon of late is it's been occurring as interest rates have been, you know, inexorably backing up. It's like the 10-year almost is screaming 3%, 3%, get there. And I don't know what will happen if we get there, because we're close to there.
Well, I don't think anything's going to happen when we get there. You have to put it in perspective, Neil, as you remember the days of super hyperinflation back in the mid to late 70s. Now we're at 2.1% inflation. We've had many, many great years. In fact, for the last 60 years, the average inflation is closer to 3%. So even if it goes up 50% from where we are now, we're just back at the average. In many, many years, in the 60s, in the 80s, the economy, GDP, unemployment have done quite well, with inflation almost double what it is now, and the Fed funds rate much higher. So I think people are used to, obviously, the lower rates, but I think there's a lot of room to go before it really becomes a concern.
Melissa, are you in the camp that higher rates are good because they say that things are good?
Well, not necessarily. I think we need growth. So it's a constant balance with the Fed. I mean, I wouldn't want that job. If you paid me $10 million a year, I wouldn't take that job. But
you consider it.
It's crazy. It's impossible. But the point is, for regular people, if they're making more money, if they feel good about their retirement and that retirement accounts are growing and they're making more, they're not going to notice a little bit more if they're paying a little bit more. It's if they're paying a lot more. That's where it's going to come out, where the cost of goods. I was surprised that number came out where it did. It overshot it. Next month, I think the market's going to react to that. Every number is going to be looked at under a microscope now, whereas before
it gets too strong.
Exactly.
What do you think, Deirdre?
Well, I'm kind of with you. Jerome Powell has his work cut out for him. But, you know, Greenspan started, I think it was like 2 months after the 1987 crash, right? So,
they all have their baptisms by fire. They can get in there.
I do think market is already pricing in 3 or 4 hikes. And to Gary's point, you know, historically, yes, we still have pretty low rates.
Gary, what if it gets beyond the 3 rate hikes at a minimum that are expected?
I think at every major number, there's going to be the market jitters, and then people are going to look around and say, my gosh, GDP is now over 3%, unemployment's dropping. Yeah, I mean, I think it's people are going to get used to it, and I still don't think inflation, because of the severe competition we have both domestically and internationally for the customer's dollars, I don't think it's going to get out of hand.
Here's what you want to look for, Neil. Follow through. Yeah. See, we didn't have the follow through this week in that sell-off. If we have the follow through in the rally this week, that's what people want to watch. That's what's important, the follow through. Is the follow through higher or is it lower? And right now, it looks like it's higher, not lower.
The follow through would mean if we retrace all the ground loss?
That's right.
Interesting. All right, guys, thank you very, very much. In the meantime, a follow through now on a little reminder by the President of the United States for higher federal gas taxes. We haven't seen one in a quarter of a century.